Hello guys, welcome back to another React Native Expo video. My name is Rohit and in this video I am going to show you how to build a language translating app using React Native Expo. This app will allow you to translate text from one language to another using the powerful GPT-3.5 Turbo Language Model. Let's get started. To begin, let's initialize an Expo app. Select the blank template, name your application and continue to download the necessary dependencies. If you encounter any error, please don't hesitate to reach me out. You can find my social media links in the description. Feel free to connect with me there. For this project, we will need two external dependencies, Axios and React Native Dropdown Picker. So let's install them one by one. You can see that I am using the latest version of these dependencies. Now to organize our project, let's create a separate source folder. Inside the folder, create an index.js file. Once that's done, let's make a simple component in the index.js file and name it translate app. Don't forget to import this component in the app.js file. Now let's run the project to make sure everything is working fine. Great. The Expo app renders a text component which shows that our app is functioning properly. Now let's head towards the index.js file and start writing some code. First, we import the necessary modules from React Native and Axios for making HTTP requests. Additionally, we use the useState hook from React Native to manage the state of our app. Here we initialize the state variables using the useState hook. We have input text to store the text that the user wants to translate, translated text to store the translated output, and from language and to language to keep track of the selected languages for translation. We also use the open from and open to handle the visibility of the language selection dropdowns. The API key required for using the OpenAI API is declared as API_key. Make sure you replace the placeholder with your actual API key obtained from OpenAI. For the API key, go to OpenAI platform. If you don't have an account, make sure to create one first and then follow the video. If you go to the users section and scroll down, you can see the expires date. Make sure that your API usage doesn't expire. If it expires, there are two methods to proceed. The first is to pay and proceed, and the second one is to make a new account with a new email and a new phone number. If you add your old phone number, it will work the same way. and you will see an error with status code 429 on your mobile app display. Here, we will use the latest GPT model's endpoint. If you purchase the $20 subscription, then you can add the latest GPT-4 model here. Others can continue with the other models. Here I am using the GPT-3.5 turbo model. The core functionality of the apps lies in the translate text function. When the user presses the translate button, this function is executed. It uses Axios.post to make a post request to the OpenAI API. The request contains the user's input text, selected source and target languages, and other necessary details like model and maximum tokens. The API responds with the translated text, which is extracted from the response and stored in the translated text state variable. The keyboard is also dismissed after the translation is completed. The return statement contains the JSX code that defines the app's UI. We begin by adding the app's title and applying some styling to it. Next, we include two dropdowns for selecting the translation languages. The left dropdown determines the source language and the right dropdown determines the target language. Following that, we add an input box for entering the text to be translated. Finally, we implement a button to trigger the translation process along with a section to display the translated text. That's it. You can now see that our app translates text into the specified target language. It functions similar to Google Translator. Now feel free to customize the code to meet your specific requirements. If you found this video helpful, please show your support by giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to our channel. Stay tuned for more React Native Expo videos in the future. See you next time.